I cannot believe that I'm saying this, but everywhere I went to in Samarkand, I was treated like a celebrity. I'm not even kidding. I spent about 3 weeks in Uzbekistan out of my 2.5 months in Central Asia, and as a solo female traveler from India, I was blown away by the warm hospitality of the people here. It also made me wonder, why are they so fond of Indians when honestly, we hardly know anything about them? I'm Raksha. I'm in the epicenter of Samarkand, which is like Registan Square. Before we get into that, I wanted to talk about the people of Uzbekistan because, let's be honest, travel is more about the people than anything else.
Eh? Mamuksa!
Like this.
Yeah. Mada.
You know, there are not many places in the world where Indians are given celebrity status, but in Uzbekistan, everyone wants to take a picture with you because you're from the home of, wait for it, Bollywood. The locals approach me, ask me where I'm from, and when I say I'm from India, they're like Hindustan, they're like so excited, they greet me with Namaste, and they grin widely showing off their golden tooth. Shah Rukh Khan is insanely popular here.
India.
So is Mithun Chakraborty. The Jimmy sensation is just unbelievable. Imagine traveling to a country so offbeat that you have no idea what to expect and then you feel like home. And that too as a solo female traveler. Needless to say, it was so special to me. And if you think this is just my experience, wait till you hear from my fellow traveler and vlogger who also traveled to Uzbekistan.
I know we usually travel together, but Uzbekistan was the one time I traveled on my own as a solo traveler. And you know, it's just been so amazing to even today think about those memories because of how nice the people were. And you won't believe, like, so many restaurants that I went to have a meal, I got the special Indian discount, which was just because I'm Indian. They relate to so many things that we do, whether it's, you know, the movies, the music, the food.
It's just such a majestic structure. That's, I think, the first thing that hits you, that it's so massive. And these structures were built in the 15th and 17th centuries. And even before that, Registan Square was once a noisy and bustling bazaar, and where caravanserai roadside inns existed to cater to merchants and travelers traveling along the Silk Road. Now it has three imposing structures, intricately decorated madrasas, which are essentially universities, Ulugbek, Tilakari, and Sherdo Madrasa. I have come here so many times before, like I was sitting there on the stairs and I was watching this magnificent structure. I have watched shows a couple of times, but this is the first time I'm actually coming inside the square here, and it's like so, just no words really. And guess what? This picture was taken moments before some middle-aged women from this group accosted me after identifying I'm from India. Did I mention the Bollywood craze here is unbelievable? Inside this madrasa, you'll find a lot of rooms on the ground and the first floor. I was told that these individual rooms on the ground floor were actually classrooms, and the upper floor hosted sleeping quarters for the students. Now, each of these are flanked by souvenir shops. Oh my god, look at the intricate details here. I was completely mind blown. I would suggest going to Registan Square 1 hour before sunset, between 5 p.m. and 6 p.m. This way you can experience the square during sunset and also when it's lit up. You would also want to watch the light show that happens here every night at 9 p.m. I'll talk about how safe it is here in a full travel guide to Uzbekistan, but for now, let me narrate this particular instance from Registan Square when I was shooting with my tripod. So I had my phone on my tripod and I was like shooting a walking scene,
And police approaches me and asks me if that is my phone, because it was, you know, a lonely phone lying there. He thought maybe the phone is like lost or stolen or something, and he wanted to make sure that, you know, it is my phone. So he came and asked me about it. You see tourist police everywhere in Uzbekistan. And I feel like these countries are so misrepresented, especially because they have the word stans in it. It has to be one of the safest countries that I've traveled to as a solo female traveler, and I don't say that lightly. This is the original mausoleum, after which the rest of the mausoleums were built around it. And photography is not allowed there, so I'm not really shooting anything inside, but that is the innermost and the original shrine.
The name Shah-i-Zinda, which means tomb of the living king, refers to this innermost and holiest shrine. This necropolis contains some of the richest tile work in Central Asia. You will find mausoleums for Amir Timur's wives, sisters, and also important members of the royal family from the Timurid era. By the way, did you notice there's a lot more turquoise in this part of the world?
Just so beautiful. The colors of the blue are so intense. These are mausoleums where people are buried, but when you are here, you'll realize how grand these structures are. Every little detail has been well thought of. It's so intricately done. And one more thing,
these are like majolica tiles, and if you can see, these are blocks. It's not design that they've done on top of the buildings. So it takes a lot more forethought and effort to actually make this, because each of these are different colored blocks, right? So imagine the craftsmanship and the skill that would have taken to actually make something like this.
You need to go inside every mausoleum, because the tile work and the design itself is different in each one of those.
A lot of monuments in Samarkand, including this one, went through restoration starting from the Soviet rule. Many of these tombs here were controversially restored, and it's said that the brilliant tile work are unlike the original one. Nevertheless, this is Samarkand's most beloved site and worthy of a visit. Gur-i-amir, final resting place of Amir Timur, the founder of Timurid dynasty, who made Samarkand his capital and built some of the most stunning monuments that you see in Samarkand. If it wasn't clear already, Amir Timur is part of the national identity of Uzbekistan and a national hero, which is quite surprising, because in Iraq, Iran, Pakistan and India, the same Amir Timur is vilified for having massacred hundreds of thousands of people. If the name Amir Timur rings a bell, that's because he's the great-great-great-grandfather of Babur, the one who established the Mughal Empire in the Indian subcontinent. This is where he's buried. As with other Muslim mausoleums, the stones are just markers, the actual crypts are in a chamber beneath. Timur's coffin reads, "Whoever opens my tomb shall unleash an invader more terrible than I." And there's an interesting story surrounding it.
In 1941, Joseph Stalin sent a team of archaeologists to open Timur's tomb in Samarkand, Uzbekistan, much to the alarm of the local residents. 2 days later, Hitler's troops invaded Russia. This is coincidence number one. By the end of 1942, Stalin finally ordered Timur's remains to be sent back to his tomb in Samarkand. A month later, Soviets defeated the Nazis in the Battle of Stalingrad, turning the course of World War II. This is coincidence number two.
No, actually, there are no coincidences at all. But the person who believes in God, he knows that everything which is happening to us is happening for some reason.
I'm staying in a traditional Uzbek home with a central courtyard, a garden, and rooms on either side. One side where the family lives and another side where the guests live. And let me show you what it's like inside. So many carpets.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
Okay.
Yes.
Hi, how are you?
Good. Thank you.
Good.
Hi.
I finally went to Ulugbek Observatory and revisited some old places in Samarkand when I came back with my husband Monty, and also tried some really cool stuff like making pottery and so on. That will be a different video altogether pretty much at the end of this series. While Samarkand was surprising in its own way, it wasn't what I expected.
I thought there will be an old town and all the important structural monuments would be there. There is Registan, which is like the epicenter of Samarkand, and then there are like other important monuments. So they are around here, but there is not. It's not concentrated in something called an old town. So yeah, that was surprising to me, because this has like probably 2,000 years of history, but it doesn't look like it here. Look at this.
My dream of being inside the old town of an ancient city where I could imagine Silk Road caravans and bazaars finally came true in Bukhara. Also, I posed for a portrait here, which was pretty cool. More on that in the next video. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed watching it. See you soon.
Hi.